Welcome to 7 Minutes at 7, your daily dive into the Gospel of John. I'm Pastor Ryan, and this is Pastor Matt.
Hey.
Today we look at John chapter 13 and see Jesus' response to being persecuted, and it may not be what you think. Chapter 13, specifically verses 12 through 16. When he had washed their feet and put on his outer garment and resumed his place, he said to them, "Do you understand what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for so I am. If I then, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have given you an example that you also should do just as I have done to you. Truly, truly, I say to you, a servant is not greater than his master, nor is a messenger greater than the one who sent him."
So, Pastor Ryan, at least for me, chapter 13 was probably one of the hardest to read, especially after reading chapters 1 through 12. You know, Jesus is going through so much. I don't know if you've ever read just almost one a day like we've done with this, but it's really just caused me to think back on each chapter individually, on all the stories, you know, the woman at the well and you know, just everything that has happened has all led up to this point, which is such an interesting thing. You know, the Pharisees have come after him multiple times and they want to kill him. And, you know, he sneaks in the back of this festival and over and over again, you know, he feeds these 5,000 people, and over and over and over again, we see him serving and people hating him for it. Over and over and over again, we see that. And this is his response to all that.
Yeah.
It's utterly impossible to get my mind around, just because it's so countercultural. You know, even us, you know, as we go through the small little things, you know, somebody on Facebook is, you know, has a negative comment or doesn't, yeah, you know, doesn't agree with the things that we've been doing. And it's so easy for me to get down and just say, if you don't like it, I'm just going to stop.
Yeah.
And that's the opposite of what Jesus would have us do. And we see that through this chapter, especially with Simon Peter. I think it's so interesting. I just want to read for a second. He came to Simon Peter in verse 6, who said to him, "Lord, do you wash my feet?" Jesus answered him, What I am doing, you do not understand, but afterwards you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." And then Jesus said, "Hey, if I don't wash your feet, if you don't let me serve you, then you have no share with me." And Peter said, "Don't just wash my feet, but also my hands. Wash my head. Wash everything.
Yeah.
You know, serve me, God."
He went all in.
Because I want to have a part. And that's kind of, I think, where we're at. You know, we're going through this hard time. You know, we were just talking, things are hard at home, right? Things are hard at church. It's hard for pastors to constantly be pouring out. And the one thing that we look forward to all week is getting together with our flock and almost celebrating.
Yeah.
And we don't get that anymore. You know, everybody's doing it on their own. And sure, we see Facebook comments and things like that that keep us going. But it's hard. It's hard to be a pastor during all this. And this is such an excellent reminder of, hey,
yeah,
through it all, serve.
And I was speaking to someone this past week, and I was just making the comment that for us personally, you know, We never really stopped to like sort of say what was us, but I'm just so grateful that God has really given us a passion to serve the community. And mm-hmm, and in this difficult time, while we did recognize, hey, like there's some difficult things happening, we just went really like 110% serving and brainstorming and of ways to serve and having the police called on us
wasn't my fault.
You know, but it was a good thing. It was like serving and, you know, trying to meet the needs of the community. Like they, you know, they asked for the needs to be met. So, Matt, I should delete that last word. But regardless, we never really stopped to just take survey of the winds and the waves. But we just start saying, how can we just draw closer to Jesus and help other people draw closer to Jesus? And to your point about serving, it's just a beautiful thing. You know, you look at in this verse here, the section of scripture that we read between 12 and 16, where Jesus is like, this is the example that I've left for you guys to serve one another. Not just, so there's one aspect of like when things get difficult, just start serving God. But then there's another aspect of start serving other people. Just go head first into serving others. And in that situation, it was like washing the disciples' feet, like he washed the disciples' feet. And that's the example he said he left for us. And so I'm sort of left with, and I think that we can answer together as a family, what's the modern day equivalent to washing feet? So Jesus left that example of serving others in the context of washing feet. But what does that mean for us? And I think we've struggled, not struggled, but we wrestled with the most appropriate way to answer that question. So we want to pose it to you guys. What do you think is the modern day equivalent, maybe even the day, today? What's the equivalent today in this circumstance of washing each other's feet? We want to hear from you guys. What do you think is the best way to serve the community? God's called us to do it. Jesus has set an example. Now we're posing the question to our family. Let us know in the comments below, and we can't wait to hear from you guys. Amen.
Amen.